Good morning, children. Now we are learning rational numbers. Rational numbers are nothing but fractions which are in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0. So we must learn the four fundamental operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of rational numbers. So let us suppose there is a rational number a by b, and there is another rational number c by d. Add them. So a by b, addition means plus, c by d. So what are the denominators? B and d. So take LCM of b and d. It goes in b. B. So LCM is b into d. So the LCM is b into d or b. So what is the procedure we adopt? This LCM BD must be divided by this denominator. So B. So what do you get? B ones are B. So instead of that, we do like this. So B into D by B. B we cancel. You are getting D. So the quotient is D here. So D into numerator A plus again B into D by D cancel. You are getting B. The quotient is B. So B into C. So this is equal to D into A AD plus BC by B. This is the way of adding rational numbers. Let us take some numerical examples for addition. So here, take here. See this problem. How do we add? So 2 by 5 plus 8 by 3 plus minus 11 by 15 plus 4 by 5 plus minus 2 by 3. How many fractions are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fractions are there. Here we find similar fractions whose denominators are equal. 5 and 5, 3 and 3. So this can be solved by two methods. One is taking LCM at a stage. So how do you take LCM here? First denominator is 5, second denominator is 3. 1315, 5, 3. Take LCM. It goes in 5s. 5 1 is a, it doesn't go. 5 3 is a, 5 1 is a, 3. Again, it goes in 3, 1. 3 1 is a, 3. 3 1 is a, 3. 1. 3 1 is a, 3. So the LCM is 5 into 3 into 1 is nothing but 15. So LCM is 15. So that means we should make the denominators in each fraction as 15. In order to make 15, denominator must be multiplied by 3. 3 into 5, 15. Here, 5 into 3, 15. 15 ones are 15. 5 into 3, 3 into 5. So that all the denominators must be equal. We can adopt that method. or another letter. So when you want to make, so 15, so 3, so this can be as 2 into 3 by 5 into 3, multiplying the numerator and denominator, the same number, the value of the fraction does not change. Why did I multiply with 3? Because the LCM is 15. I must make all the denominators 15. So here the denominator is 3. 3 into 5. So 8 into 5 plus 15. Oh, 15 ones are only. So minus 11 into 1 plus 4 by 5. 15, 3 into 3 plus minus 2 by 3, 5 by 5, 15. So in each denominator, the LCM should resemble 15, 15, 15, 15, 15. So this can be further simplified. 2 3s are 6 by 15 plus 8 5s are 40 by 15 plus 11 ones are 11 by 15 plus 4 3s are 12 by 15 plus minus 10 by 15. So these are all similar fractions, because in each case the denominator is 15. So these fractions are called similar fractions, similar fractions. So if this is the case, numerators must be added. So what are the numerators? 6 plus 40 minus 11 plus 12 minus 10 by 15. Now here, what are the plus 1? 6, 40, 12. These three are plus quantities. So 46 plus 12, 58. So plus 58. Minus we have 2. Minus 10, minus 11. Minus 21 by 15. So this minus 21 must be made 0. So plus 21, minus 21 becomes 0. When 21 is subtracted, it is 37. So you subtract this from here. So this can be done by two methods. One is making 0 or simply subtracting. 8 minus 1, 7. 5 minus 2, 3 by 15. So what I wanted to tell you is, so take the rough call. So 58 can be written as 38 plus 27 is 58. It is split into 2 and minus 21 is already there by 15. Minus 21 plus 21 becomes 0. 31 by 15. This is another way of simplifying. So this is the way of simplifying. So you please take, instead of making like this multiplying number and denominator, even if you take LCM also, you will be getting the same one. So write the first problem and practice it by yourself, either by taking LCM or by multiplying the numerator and denominator with the same number. And the second type of problem is, here we have write the additive inverse. So here you should remember very clearly. So additive inverse of a plus quantity is becomes minus. So the additive inverse of minus quantity is plus quantity. For example, additive inverse of minus 2 is plus 2. Inverse of plus 2 is minus 2. Similarly, you take rational numbers. Inverse of minus 2 by 3 is plus 2 by 3. So this is the way of writing LD inverse. In the page number, it is 20. So you have some 4 solved examples. You can do it. In the 4th solved example, we have a different type that I shall explain very clearly. Minus 21 by minus 20. Minus 21 by minus 20. So, when minus is divided with minus, you are getting plus. You are getting plus. So, its LD inverse is plus 21 by plus 20. Or this you take individually. Or else you can take 21 by 20. So, next problem is subtract 2 by 3 from 7 by 8. Subtract 2 by 3 from 8. Which is to be subtracted? 2 by 3 is subtracted. From which quantity? Which rational number? 7 by 8. So the quantity that must be subtracted is 2 by 3. So this is 2 by 3 minus, you are subtracting this. From means it comes here. It is 7 by 8. So 7 by 8 minus 2 by 3. So here the denominator is 8 and the denominator is 3. It is a composite number. 2 4s are 3. It is a composite number. 2 2s are 3. 2 4, 8 3s are 24 is the LCM. 24 is LCM. So now LCM is making the denominators 24. How does it 8 become 24? If you multiply by 3, it becomes 24. So multiply the numerator with 3 and also denominator with 3 to make the denominator 24 LCM minus here 3 is there. How do you get 24 only by multiplying 8? So multiply the numerator by 8 and also denominator by 8. So this is 21 by 24 minus 16 by 24. So when the denominators are equal, they are single fractions. So both the fractions is 24 only denominator. So 21 minus 16. So among these two, 21 is greater. Greater. The greater has positive sign. So you can put either positive or negative positive. 21 minus 16, 5 by 24. This is equal to 5 by 24. This is the way of subtracting. And the next problem is the sum of 2 rational numbers is minus 3. One of them is माइनस 11 बाई 5 फाइंड द आंसर। नाउ द सम ऑफ टू रैशनल नंबर्स इज माइनस 3। There are two rational numbers. 3 is also a rational number. So you don't know another one, but their sum must be equal to minus 3. One of them is minus 15. Others we don't know. Other number we don't know, that we have to find the other number. So let the other number be x. X, since it is a rational number, let it be x by 1, doesn't matter. X by 1. So the other one, the other number is this one. The first number is minus 11 by 5. Sum means we must add these two. So x by 1 plus minus 11 by 5 must be equal to minus 3. According to the problem, it is minus 3 equal to minus 3. Now we must find out the value of x. What is the denominator here? 5. Here 1. So the LCM must be 5. So multiply the numerator with 5. And also the denominator also with 5. X into 5, 1 into 5, minus 11 into 1 by 5 into 1. Now this is 5x by 5 less 11 by 5. Denominators are equal, similar fractions. So this is equal to minus 3. This is also equal to minus 3. So similar fractions, 5x minus 11 is equal to minus 3. Minus 3. So we must make x alone. We must, our aim is to find out the value of x. We must make x alone. So in order to make x alone, we will have to eliminate 5, we will have to eliminate minus 11, we will have to eliminate this 5. Here only x becomes alone, so that we can find the value. So first, one is, we go for simplification division. So this 5 must be eliminated. So this 5 must be eliminated, means it must be made 1. How does it become 1? If you, it is in the place of denominator, multiply the left hand side and right hand side with 5. So 5 into, or you can use bracket, 5x minus 11 by 5 and minus 3 into 5. This 5 gets cancelled. Now you are getting minus 5x minus 11 is equal to minus 15. Now eliminate this 11, make it 0. Make it 0. Minus 11 is there. When minus 11 becomes 0, when plus 11 is added to minus 11, it becomes 0. So you must add plus 7. 5x minus 11 is already there. You are adding 11 to the left hand side. Similarly, you must do the same thing to the right hand side. Adding 11 to the left and right side of the equation, the value does not change. So this becomes 0. This becomes 0. So 5x is equal to minus 15 plus 11. Minus 15 plus 11. 1 minus, 1 plus, you must subtract. Minus is greater. So the resultant number carries minus. So 5x is equal to, if you subtract, you are getting minus 4. Minus 4. So So you are getting minus 4. Now x must be made alone. But 5 is multiplied to x. So the quotient of x must be 1. How does the quotient of x will become 1? By multiplying by 5. 5x by 5, left hand side only divided 5. So right hand side also the same thing. So 5 cancel, you are getting 1. 1x is equal to minus 4 by 5. Minus 4 by 5. So the other number is minus 4 by 5. So let us see whether our answer is correct or not. Not looking at the back of the answers. We can do it. What is the one number? Minus 11 by 5. What is the number we have got? Minus 4 by 5. Both the denominators are same. So 5. Minus 11 plus minus 4. So you are getting minus 15. Minus 15 by 5. So this is 5 on the 5 minus 3 is minus 3. So the sum is minus 3. So our problem is correct. Our problem is correct. This is the way of verification. You don't look at the back to verify your answer. You can calculate, you can verify the answer by this method. Thank you.